In this video, I will give you a brief introduction to BSIRAD, a homemade automatic powder dispenser based upon an ordinary beam scale. I will show you how it all works. Let the journey begin. To prepare BSIRAD for service, make sure that BSIRAD is standing on a solid, straight surface. Lift off the lid and move the beam from its rest position to its working position. Place the powder trickler in its holder and firmly connect the feeding pipe to the coupling. Hook up the pan to the beam. Connect the power adapter to BSIRAD and to a power outlet. It takes less than 30 seconds for BSIRAD to start. I spent $37 on this build, but then I already had an RCBS M500 beam scale, an old Raspberry Pi model B. I also nicked cables, connectors and spacer screws from a disposed computer. I also used offcuts and other waste. BSIRAD will start with displaying its software version. Then BSIRAD will calibrate. The calibration locates the beam and the scale tags. The camera placement is rather unrestrained. The scale compartment hosts a beam scale, a web camera, and a simple LED illumination. BSIRAD's user interface consists of a simple LCD display and 8 momentary push buttons. The yellow button is used to zero the scale. The green button forces recalibration. A short push on the red button immediately stops an ongoing load. A long push takes you into a menu where you can choose from different actions. The blue and the black buttons are load buttons. Each load button can be programmed with its own feed characteristics to optimize for specific loads. As with any beam scale, you need to zero it. To be on the safe side, we start with forcing a recalibration by pressing the green button. That is strictly speaking not necessary, as we just booted. Take the lid off. Move the scale weights to their zero positions. Then press the yellow button to start the zeroing process. The display will show the weight deviation. Adjust the scale to zero in the ordinary way with the help of the display. It is generally a good idea to wait until the powder pan is not swinging too much. It also helps if you turn the adjustment wheel the right direction. And there we're done. Let's make some air draft by waving our hand to see if the scale are returning to zero. A solution like this will never be better than the scale. And there we're back to zero. Press the red stop button to return to idle mode. Let's throw a load. I have filled the trickler with Norma's N202 powder and set the scale to 42.6 grains. The speed of the stepper motor is continuously adjusted and depends upon the beam's speed, acceleration, direction and forecasted balance position. The feed algorithm is designed to work against beam swinging. If you look and listen carefully, you will notice that the speed of the feeder increases when the powder pan is turning upwards. As you can see, BSIRAD returns to idle mode immediately after the pan is lifted off. BSIRAD also recalibrates when the beam reaches its rest position. The software is constructed so you don't have to have the camera fixed to the scale. The camera can be freely placed in front of the scale. After this throw, I shall not bore you anymore with loading Norma N202. Instead, I'm going to bore you with loading Vihtavuori N32C, also known as Tin Star. Before that, I'm going to move the camera forward, so you will get a closer look on the actual feed. As you will notice, there is not much of a time difference between loading 42.6 grains and 9 grains. That is due to the fact that most of the load time is used for trickling the last quarter grain. The bulk load is pretty fast. Oh, this looks bad. That was very close to overcharge. No trickling at all, only bulk feed. This indicates that my settings for this load are slightly too aggressive. Let's manually add a few powder kernels. As you can see, the display changes from finished to overcharge. The overcharge limit can be set individually for each load button. For this load, I've set it to 0.02 grains. Let's make some draft to make the scale swing. Notice how the display is showing that the beam is unstable instead of showing the weight difference. This first video is just a teaser. In the upcoming episodes, we will disassemble BSIRAD and have a closer look at its components. We will also explore more of BSIRAD's functionality. Subscribe, we will have fun together.